When Joab, who had been on patrol, returned and learned the news, he chastised David and sent a message for Abner to return, without David's knowledge. He killed Abner while greeting him on the way. David washed his hands of the murder. Abner's deal went through quickly despite his death. The elders in Israel said, David was the one who delivered us from the Philistines so many times, not Saul. So David became king of all Israel. He ruled in Hebron for 7 years. He ruled in Jerusalem for 30 years. The Jebusites who lived in Jerusalem taunted David. They said, if we were blind, crippled, you couldn't take Jerusalem from us. So David put it to the army of Israel. Whoever kills the first Jebusite will lead the army. Joab found a way into the city through a water tunnel and killed the first Jebusite. They called Jerusalem the city of David. David just kept getting bigger and stronger. Kings came to him wanting to be friends. Others David destroyed. He got into Philistia so far and hard, he captured the Philistine idols. In his zeal, David began to move the Ark of God back into Jerusalem. After difficulty and 3 months of deliberation, it was finally accomplished. David danced with the Ark along its entire route into the city. He removed his robes and was in full boogie as they entered Jerusalem's gates. Michal, Saul's daughter, and David's wife, told David she was embarrassed about the display. David stopped spending any time with Michal. David began thinking about building a temple for the Lord. David said, I have a fine house. It's time for the Lord to get one. The Lord spoke to David through the prophet Nathan. I did not ask for a house, and you won't build it. I will build you a house. When you die, one of your descendants will build a house for me, and I will establish his kingdom forever. I will be his father, and he will be my son. David went on to defeat more Arabs. He tried to do right by Jonathan and Saul. The only living relative he could find was Jonathan's son, crippled the day his father died. His name was Mephibosheth. David began to spend more time in Jerusalem. Joab was running the army, and the army was putting it to whoever they decided. Every neighboring nation was paying tax to David. David was stocking it away and building garrisons all over. One spring, Joab and the army were out killing Arabs. David stayed in town. David was on his roof late one afternoon, and he saw a beautiful woman named Bathsheba bathing below. He sent for her, and they had intercourse, and she got pregnant. Problem, she was married to Uriah, one of the top 30 most valiant officers in the army. Uriah had been with David before Ziklag.